Vow and Declare has defied the international assault on the Melbourne Cup to produce a truly homegrown win for Australian racing. The four-year-old provided trainer Danny O'Brien and jockey Craig Williams with breakthrough victories in the greatest race of all. Tony Jones begins our coverage.
The weather gods gave Flemington a bit of a break today, and punters aplenty came hoping their own prayers would be answered. But none more so than the connections of Vow and Declare, the horse in many ways carrying the hopes of Australia. Soon after 3 o'clock, those prayers were put to the test.
Ready to go, stalls are back and they're racing. Nerf bossed Veer to the right and bumped into Magic Wand shortly after the start.
That start had set the scene for the drama that would soon follow. It's dubbed the Great Race, and few finishes in the Cup have been as great as this one.
It's Bastard Reality. Vow and Declare up on the inside. Vow and Declare, Prince of Arid is lifting late with El Paradiso. Bastard Reality just in front. Vow and Declare kicks. Vow and Declare's won it for Australia. They're on top of the world.
Every Cup winner has a special story attached to it, but Vow and Declare produced several, not least his trainer, Danny O'Brien, who almost lost everything during the Cobalt scandal. He fought, he survived, and today was the knockout blow.
Yeah, it's an amazingly special thing to happen. I really can't believe it. I feel incredibly blessed, you know, to have a horse good enough to be in it, and then for him to be ridden so beautifully by Craig.
This was a family affair for the O'Briens. Son Thomas, very much in Dad's corner.
Oh my God, I've been waiting years for this moment.
And then there's Craig Williams. Having won just about everything Australian racing has to offer, he now finally has a Melbourne Cup. And the adulation didn't fall on deaf ears.
Danny O'Brien's got a fantastic story with him that no one... Thank you very much, guys.
Soon, Williams was trekking down that famous pathway back to the mounting yard. With every step, the realisation was sinking in that he'd finally bagged the big one. There was some hurly-burly during the race, and mid-interview, an edgy Williams was stopped mid-sentence by a PA announcement.
I grew up and... What's that?
His fears of a protest were unfounded. Nothing would deny him this win.
Again, it's not just a handicap anymore. It's the greatest race on earth, and thanks for everyone
sure
that got me there.
Well done, Craig.
Craig Williams wasn't completely wrong about a protest. There was one, fourth against second, both trained by Aidan O'Brien. Therefore, it was the stewards who lodged the protest. As a result, Master of Reality was relegated from second to fourth. Prince of Arran slipped into second, and Il Paradiso is the new third place getter. It had no bearing whatsoever on the newfound status of Vow and Declare, a Melbourne Cup champion, who, through sheer courage and a brilliant ride, turned Cup Day into Australia Day. Tony Jones, 9 News.